You'd be hard-pressed to find a family in New Mexico that has another cutback or reevaluated their spending habits in this tough economy. So have our public agencies been doing the same?
Well, you may be surprised how much we're still spending when it comes to funding public information or communication departments, people who talk to us, the media. Target 7's Lauren Zakalik has more on this developing story.
Doug Shelley, today Superintendent Brooks tells me the district is facing a $31 million deficit. Now, with that in mind, how much they're currently paying their communications department may shock you.
In the years Terry Hamilton has been an APS parent, she's seen a 180 when it comes to what the district pays for and what it doesn't.
Parents are having to pay more for lab fees and PE clothes and, you know, everything that affects the kids, the parents are having to make up.
Adding and subtracting is easy.
Even her daughter, a junior at Rio Grande, has had to pick up a part-time job to pay for school supplies and extracurriculars. It's this new reality, less money for kids in the classroom and a $31 million deficit that has Terry begging the district to check its priorities.
Communications, I think there's too much money in communications.
APS's communications and web department is made up of 8 people, 4 communication specialists, 3 web people, and 1 secretary. They manage all communications for the district, and for that, they're well paid. Executive Director Monica Armenta makes about $107,000 a year. In addition, Director Rigo Chavez makes more than $70,000. Add in the other 6 salaries, and taxpayers are shelling out almost $500,000 to communicate with us, the media.
The communications web department is more or less the 24/7 operation for the district. We handle crisis management, we handle messaging to parents, we handle the website.
Armenta says they're not teachers, but their job is a must for a successful school system. Meantime, the average teacher makes about $43,000, according to the teachers union. So for all that money, how quickly does the communications department respond to our questions? Well, it took more than a week for the communications department to give us the requested salary information. And when we called Rigo Chavez to ask about the holdup, he hung up when we said we were recording.
In that case, I'm hanging up. Goodbye.
The next day, Armenta would not respond when Target 7 asked if Superintendent Brooks really needed 8 people to communicate with the public.
It's hard to answer that without sounding defensive or, worse yet, arrogant.
But it's not just Target 7 that's asking these tough questions. So is our new governor, Susana Martinez.
New Mexicans are not fooled when bureaucrats, whose salaries are many times that of the average teacher, claim the only place to cut is from the classroom. They're not fooled when a school district spends hundreds of thousands of dollars on PR staff and then claims it has nowhere to cut but the classroom.
We asked Superintendent Winston Brooks about his belt tightening within the communications department. He told Target 7 each administrative department will take a nearly 13% cut this year. As far as he knows, there are no plans to cut pay for the top salary earners in communications.
In addition to the nearly 13% cuts each non-school department will be making, the superintendent says every school will be having to cut about 5% as well to make up for that deficit. Shelley.